them smaller.
Yeah.
You know, it's a funny thing. I've made fries. I don't like calling them French fries, but just fries. I've made them on
Freedom fries.
You know, you ever have a sweet potato fries?
Yes.
Those are great. And then yes. I've also made squash fries, fries out of squash. I'm telling you, you can make fries out of a lot of different things. Next time I'm going to try eggplant fries.
It is.
Actually, I already have tried eggplant fries. So they are good. Yeah. So, but anyway, Well, you know, this is the time of year when people got a lot of stuff in their garden, but there's going to be 251 very happy wolf applicants because they're going to be getting their permits this year to trap or shoot a wolf in the state of Wisconsin. So that's what I thought. Let you know.
Or shoot.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, there's a group out there. I forget what their name is. There's a group out there.
The Wolf Preservation Society.
Yeah, something like that. They've actually got a handbook. Yeah, they got a handbook that tells people how to disrupt a wolf hunt or how to screw up the traps that the trappers put out and all that stuff.
But that's illegal. The DNR can give you a huge fine
right.
for that.
That's right. And I hope they do.
How about we put a big snare for those guys? You know? Like, you set the wolf trap in an obvious spot.
Yeah.
And then you have open a bent sapling where when they step on it,
hangs them up in the air by their ankle.
Hangs them up in the air. Yep.
That would be cool.
Yep.
Yeah. Leave them for a couple of days. The more you struggle, the tighter it gets.
And then we wait for the crows come to pick at their eyes. Yeah. Yeah. Let's get
that'll
those hands.
That'll teach them.
Yeah, now we'll get a new, good gut report for that one.
Yeah. So.
Eyeballs.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. No, we don't want to do that. Oh, okay. This past Sunday, my son Chris and I went out to Oconomowoc Lake. We didn't get out there until like 9 o'clock in the morning. We didn't start fishing until maybe like 9:15. We fished till about 1:30. But I've got some good news.
What's the good news?
The good news is, okay, we caught about a half a dozen largemouth, but we caught many more smallmouth.
Oh, you did that, so you
yes back, more
because we couldn't find the smallies much this summer.
Yeah, we only caught a few smallies, but a lot of largemouth.
Yeah,
this time, you know, we caught about a half dozen largemouth. Biggest was maybe 17, 18 inches, and then the smallies, we got a bunch of those. Biggest ones were about 17, 18 inches. The neat thing about the smallies. The largemouth, well, let's start with the largemouth. The largemouth, there were, I think out of the half a dozen, three or four were legal. Yeah. Two or three were not. The smallies, every one was 15 to 18 inches. Every one was legal.
And they fight like crazy.
Oh, man, they were awesome. And jumping and flying out of the water, doing their act. And this was cool, too. My son was casting in. We were break line, okay, most of the time. But we got back in some of these bays where you got that shallow sand flats.
Yeah.
And my son was casting to the weed clumps that were closer to shore where you'd have an inside weed line, a little outside weed line, you know. But it wasn't real deep water. And out to the open part of the lake, it was just like 4 feet of water, 4 or 5 feet of water and just sand, right?
Yeah.
So I just started, I'm just going to take some shots out that way.
Into the sand.
Into nowhere, right? Yeah. Into the abyss. And I'd stand up and I'd look. I couldn't see nothing, but by golly, there were fish out there.
Really?
One of them was so cool because they had the salty sinker out. It was the salty sinker. I'd made a long cast, and all of a sudden, to my left, I see this smallie. So I just reel in my bait so that it gets about 5 feet from it and let it sink. And that fish turned right around, came at it, and it was facing me when it came up to the bait. Those, you know, smallies, even though they have got a smaller mouth than a large mouth, they can open it up pretty wide.
Right.
Because I'm looking dead on at it, and I gave it a little twitch. He came up and opened that mouth, sucked it right in with its fish vacuum pulling power. And we had a really good time.
Say that again.
Fish vacuum pulling power. When the fish's mouth
like
is
Electrolux.
Closed. Yeah, when their mouth is closed.
It's a Hoover.
And then open it, it goes from nothing, you know, there's like a vacuum, open your mouth, anything in front of it just gets sucked in. But here's the other thing. Remember last week how we had several reports from guys? Bill Beal over at Sportsman's Den was one of them.
Yep.
Big bluegills were in shallow water.
Yeah.
Well, we didn't find them in shallow water. We went gill fishing to take something home.
On Oconomowoc?
Yes, and we were in, the weed line was probably about, we were catching gills in 12 to 16 feet of water.
Okay.
And, I mean, we caught some little ones, but the ones we took home were all between like 8 to 9 inches.
Nice ones.
Yeah, very nice ones.
Nice ones. Oh,
very nice gills on, guess what? The mini mites, yeah, all mini mites, of course. And what's really weird is that orange mini mite, even my son Chris was telling me, he was out at another lake. I think he was out at Moose Lake the week before, and he said that his girlfriend winged the white mini mite, and he's throwing the orange, and he's getting fish at, you know, crappies and bluegills, and she couldn't get a bite. He put an orange one on her line. She starts catching them. There's something about that goofy orange mini mite. I don't know what it is. I mean, we catch fish on the white ones, too.
I like the orange one.
But that orange one just...
With the green or white head?
It's got the chartreuse green
head. Yeah, the green head.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. There's some color like orange, you know, that they're just sucking in like crazy. But anyway, so I, you know, after hearing the reports of the big bluegills in shallow, we didn't catch any big bluegills in shallow, but we went out to the weed line, and by golly, they were all out there. So you know what? I guess it all depends on what lake you're fishing. They're either shallow, deep, or somewhere in between.
They're always in a lake somewhere. We can say that.
That's right. Manny says we got to go to a break. So, John, where are we going to go?
We're going to go to a break.
All right.
You're listening to Cutting Edge Outdoors on 1250 WSSP, casting from beautiful downtown Hales Corners.
Just in case you missed the Wendy's Varsity Blitz scoreboard show last night, here are some of the winning coaches. Big time Mike McGivern and Hall of Fame coach Ron Davies caught up with. First up, Rob Green from Brown Deer.
Well, our offense, we broke our lead, and then Walkie Luke in that last fight, they kept on coming back on us. And so, you know, it was a hard fought game, and we got to clean up some mistakes as we grow.
McGuanago's head coach Clay Iverson with his team's win over Racine Horlick.
I'll tell you what, our kids hung in there. They played really hard. It was a game of a lot of different swings. I think you get that sometimes, especially in the first game when you try to figure a few things out. But we hung in there well and beat a quality opponent. They're going to win a lot of football games. So it's always good to get when you schedule a tough non-conference, and then you get an opportunity to win that those conference.
And University Schools head coach Brian Summers.
Nice win against Milwaukee South tonight. Coach, congratulations.
Yeah, they played hard. A lot of stakes, but we'll take the 48-0.
Be sure to tune into the Wendy's Varsity Blitz scoreboard show every Friday night from 7 to 10 p.m. and follow that up with the Varsity Blitz coaches show Saturday mornings starting at 10 here on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Hi, my name is Anthony. I'm 8 years old and I'm a children's champion. When I was born, my heart wasn't working like there was like a hole in it. Children's Hospital saved my life.
Support Children Briggs and Al's Run and Walk on September 14th. Register online at alsrun.com.
The money goes to the hospital so they can help kids get better.
Kids deserve the best.
So what does it feel like to get the greatest haircut on earth at Lady Jane's in Greenfield? What does a soothing shampoo, scalp massage, and a hot lather neck shave feel like? Well, you know when the stud running back on your fantasy football team tweaks his knee and all you have left is an inferior player? Then out of nowhere, he goes off for 200 yards and 3 touchdowns? That's what it feels like to get the greatest haircut on earth at Lady Jane's in Greenfield on 76th Street, just south of Layton Ave, next to Barnes & Noble. Lady Jane's, it's wicked awesome.
Hi, this is Captain Mel Christensen. I'm a full-time fishing guide and would like to show you the great fishing that is available on Lake Delavan or Geneva, two of the best lakes in southern Wisconsin for bass or pike. I provide all the equipment, so all you have to do is book the trip and have a good time. Visit my website, fishwithmel.com, or call me at 815-678-7051. 815-678-7051.
Hunting season is here. Get ready for the best time of the year. Midwest Outdoors Magazine stands ready with you, loaded with tips, ideas, and destinations to make this the best fall ever. Get 12 big issues for only $14.95. Call 1-800-606-FISH. Each issue is packed with information and entertainment, including the Wisconsin section, featuring fishing reports on all area hotspots and updates on what every outdoorsman wants to know. Call 1-800-606-FISH and subscribe to Midwest Outdoors Magazine.
Spring is right around the corner, and the lake is soon to be open. When it's time to take a break from the water, come and grab some grub from Curly's Waterfront Pub. We serve the coldest tappers, great sandwiches, and have the best homemade pizza in town. We've got hard-to-beat happy hour specials and fantastic daily food specials, too. When the sun goes down, enjoy trivia on Thursdays, karaoke on Fridays, and live music every Saturday night. We are located on the south end of Pewaukee Lake by Smokey's Bait Shop. There's a stool waiting for you.
There's big news at Skipper Buds. Sure, you know them for selling big boats, but did you know about their fishing boat lineup? Skipper Buds is now selling a complete line of StarCraft fishing boats. Let's not forget about pontoon boats. StarCraft offers versatile cruise and fish models. Plus, this year, there is float boat pontoons, all powered by dependable Mercury engines. So if you're looking for the best price on a complete fishing rig, don't wait. Head on over to Skipper Buds in Pewaukee on Silver Nail Road. Check out their website at skipperbuds.com. That's skipperbuds.com.
Are you an experienced CNC turning and machining center operator? Component Engineering, Inc. is now seeking qualified applicants to fill positions in their CNC machining departments. Applicants must be able to do setup and editing on Fanuc and Mazak controllers. 5 access and machining center experience a plus. Component Engineering offers an excellent benefit package. Qualified applicants apply in person Monday through Thursday between 6 a.m. and 3 p.m. or Friday mornings from 7 a.m. until 3 in the afternoon. Component Engineering, Inc. 1610 Independence Avenue, Hartford, Wisconsin. Call them right now, 262-673-0511. That's 262-673-0511.
Monday morning on Chuck and Wicket, you could win $1,000 at plus the latest on Ryan Braun with our Brewers insider Adam McKelvey. Then at 8:15, we'll look back at Packers and Seahawks preseason game number 3 with our insider Tyler Dunn. We'll see you Monday on Chuck and Wicket, Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
What is satisfied? What is not a buy? What you think, boy, is crying? Ain't it crying? If I could win, if I could sing,
hey, welcome back to the Cutting Edge Outdoors. We've got Archie on the line right now, so let's talk to him. Good morning, Archie. You're live on the Cutting Edge Outdoors. What's on your mind this morning?
Oh, lots of stuff. Just getting off work. I just couldn't help but I overheard John mention a little something about scalping earlier, and I was just wondering if he had any personal views on...
don't get him started.
This is nothing inappropriate.
What's the question?
A lot of political issues that get involved with American Indian rights towards fishing, and so forth. I wonder if John had any personal views on that that he can talk about.
Now John has no views on
that. He's formulating something right now.
Yeah. Archie, what did you want? My view and opinion on how many scalp...
No.
American Indian rights and his views to the fishing on the tribal land.
Yeah. It's frowned on today.
I don't think John knows what he's talking about. Hey, thanks, Archie.
No, Archie.
Thanks for the call, Archie.
Thank you, Archie. We appreciate it. Just trying to rile John up.
He's trying to rattle your cage.
What's my
opinion? What do you think about taxes for small businesses, John?
John was trying to get something out there.
John, I went out and looked at your truck.
Yeah, that's nice. It's a nice burgundy color.
It's a nice truck.
You got the big four-door truck, and it's so long, I don't think there's some parking spots you won't be able to go in. You're going to have to take up two.
Get this. Get this, Tom. You would have put it in reverse in a camera.
He's got the camera in the rearview mirror.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
And you know what? That really confuses me because I don't know if I'm going forwards or backwards.
Here's the thing. With John's ADHD, you can't have too many distractions for him. So now he's looking in a rearview mirror, and he's got a camera with another screen with his eyes darting back and forth between that, the side mirrors, and trying to look over his head. It's for sure a recipe for backing into something. It's a recipe for disaster. Why? Does it have the automatic brake? Why don't you go out there? Go out and see if you can back into this pillar out here and see if it automatically brakes for you. Like, some vehicles have that automatic brake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You might have that.
I think those are BMWs or something like that.
I'll tell you, technology's really come a long way.
It hasn't helped me much.
Well, the old truck looked like it'd been in like a bumper in a demolition derby.
Yeah, and you gotta put that your cutting edge outdoor stickers on that truck.
Yeah,
you've got one of the red. You've got the red, I think, which might match okay with that burgundy. Do you think red? Maybe white. I don't know.
Yeah, white maybe. Yeah. I don't know. It seems like chrome matches everything.
But don't overdo it with stickers and stuff. Yeah. Like, I've got very few on my truck. I like to keep it looking clean. I don't want to put about 1,800.
The only one I have is in the back says Cutting Edge Outdoors.
Yeah. Some people kind of put junk there, too much.
No, some people have so many bumper stickers, you can't even read them. I mean, there's so many stuck together. And
bumper stickers are for beaters.
Yeah.
If you got, yeah, if you got,
if you got a little.
To make no fun place. Of me this time.
No, I think somebody was just trying to get you riled up.
No.
They were asking
what you. Give them an answer on scalping.
No, not on scalping. About in the Native Americans and how they maybe spear or something. I don't know how they fish.
Oh, you wouldn't let Archie talk. So
yeah, we did. He asked you twice
if you had any viewpoints on that, how you felt about the Native American spearing rights and this and that in northern Wisconsin.
How they fish on their ceded territory.
And how you felt about that? Right. Actually, and Tom would have been the one to get riled up about that. I think our guests are coming in. I see Tom Kemp's son on the parking lot. I'm going to walk outside.
All right. I'm trying to get a hold. See, I'm really.
What are you doing?
Watch. Listen. I'm trying to get a hold of Sal Marchese. He won't answer his phone.
So you are the phone guy.
I am. Yeah, well, I'm on my cell phone.
Jeez.
The show is a well-oiled machine.
Yeah. I don't know what he's doing. Yeah, he's probably working. He goes to work early and all that, you know, every day. So, but yeah, I'm just going to tell people because we got guests coming in. Sal, I forget that there's a little town out near Holy Hill. Now, do you remember?
Monchez.
It's not Monchez. I would know the name if I heard it. But do you remember, John, do you remember last year when the DNR guy, he had trail cams out. He lives out by West Bend area, and he got a picture of a cougar. In the not far from the town of West Bend.
Right.
Okay. Sal and his son, they were leaving one of his wife's relatives' homes. This past week, last weekend. They're leaving the house, right? And they just pull out the driveway. They're going down the road, and his son says, "Wow, Dad, look, that's a big cat."
No.
Sal looks. He says, "That's not just a big cat. That's a cougar." Yeah, right out not far from Holy Hill. Yeah, right there it was, wow. Right in front of him. Right in front of him.
164?
No, well, I don't know what highway or whatever, but there it was.
Is that by Sussex?
No, that's far away from Sussex. That's a long ways away from there. So I wish Sal would be around so that we could get his.
Did he see the cougar crossing the road?
No, it was on
the
side.
Crossing the road?
No.
How does a cat cross the road?
Why
does it cross the road?
Oh, that's a joke. Oh, yeah. Why does it? Okay. So, was it in a field or was it running?
No, it was just along the side of the road.
He just said it crossed the road.
No, I didn't say it crossed the road. I just said it was on the side of the road.
Why does a cat cross the road?
Get to the other side.
John has no idea.
So
it's 7 o'clock.
Was it a big cougar?
He said it was. He said it was big, yeah.
Yeah, well, any cougar is going to be big if I look at it.
Unless it's a baby cougar, John. Hey, it's 7 o'clock. We got to go. We do have guests in the studio. We will be introducing them as soon as we come back into the second hour. Right, John?
Yes, we will be. You're listening to the Cutting Edge Outdoors on 1250 WSSP, Milwaukee Sports Leader.
The 1250 Milwaukee Sports Report starts right now.
From the Legends of the Field Sports Radio 1250 Update Studio, I am Matt Barlow. Legends of the Field, a sports memo video company you can trust. Let's start with the Packers last night. It was preseason game number 3 for Green Bay as they played host to the Seattle Seahawks. The final from Lambeau Field Friday night was Seattle 17, the Packers 10. The only touchdown of the game for the Packers came from a 1-yard pass from Vince Young. There might not have been a lot of offense in the game, but tight end Jermichael Finley feels good and likes the way him and quarterback Aaron Rodgers are communicating.
Like I say, being at practice every day, not missing a day, and just communicate. Communication is on point right now. Loving it, and just can't wait to see what we got for 16 games straight.
The Brewers were also in action last night visiting the Cincinnati Reds. Young Brewers outfielder Chris Davis stayed hot, hitting 2 home runs, giving him 4 RBIs for the game. And second baseman Scooter Jeanette added a home run of his own. The Brewers used that offense to get a win. The final was the Crew 6. The Reds for Gardo was a starting pitcher. He went 6 innings, throwing 108 pitches, giving up 3 runs. 2 of them were earned. Jim Henderson came in the ninth to shut the door, getting the save. Other Brewers news, some teammates have commented on Ryan Braun's apology for using PEDs. Manager Ron Renicki stated, "I don't care how people are going to tear this apart and critique it. It doesn't matter what he says. Try to do what you think you need to do." WSSP's own Jonathan Lucroy was also quoted, "I thought this was a good first step on the road to redemption." Reborn all these stories at sportsradio1250.com. From WSSP weather tonight, clear skies and a low of 60. Tomorrow it's going to be sunny with a high of 80 degrees. Right now it's about clear and 65 degrees. I'm Matt Barlow, and you're listening to Sports Radio 1250 WSSP, streaming live worldwide online at sportsradio1250.com.
Packers fans, let's head to Title Town for a green and gold update brought to you by Paper Machinery Corporation.
Hi, I'm Mike Clemens in Green Bay. The Packers lose 17-10 to the Seahawks. Seattle has now won 8 preseason wins in a row, dating back to 2011. 6 players added to the Packers' injury list, including linebacker Brad Jones, safety Morgan Burnett, and defensive back Casey Hayward, all with hamstrings, running back DeJuan Harris with a sore knee. Quarterback Graham Harrell was just 6 of 13 for 49 yards, missing a touchdown pass to Jermichael Finley. Mike McCarthy.
Well, it's once again, this isn't all on the quarterback. The goal tonight was to play everybody, particularly get some guys in earlier. This will give us a very clean, accurate evaluation.
That's Packers head coach Mike McCarthy from Lambeau Field. Mike Clemens, WSSP.
The Green and Gold Update was brought to you by Paper Machinery Corporation. Paper Machinery Corporation in Milwaukee is expanding and looking to hire a few CNC machinists. Apply for a job and get a career with Paper Machinery Corporation. Call 414-354-8050 or log on to papermc.com. Your Brewers catcher, Jonathan Lucroy, Tuesday mornings at 8:35 with Chuck and Wicket on the only station Brewers fans need. Sports Radio 1250 WSSP Milwaukee. SSSFM HD2 Wauwatosa.
The following is paid commercial programming. The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of 1250 WSSP Milwaukee, its staff, or sponsors.
Good morning, your life. Outdoors.
I have a hibiscus, and I wonder if it needs trim back. Let it grow as it is.
Shirley, do you know what show you're calling?
Some weeks I don't know what the heck I'm listening to.
This is the Cutting Edge Outdoors. We talk about fishing and hunting and other goofy stuff.
Oh, I guess I don't.
The CEO is a good, honest, tasty show at a tasty price. They are free. You better believe it.
Lacrosse is Canada's biggest sport.
I thought it was hot.
No, not even close.
What the hell's going on out here?
Thank the music.
Crazy, and that's how it goes on the crazy train with the CEO. That's the Cutting Edge Outdoors on 1250 WSSP, Milwaukee sports leader. I'm in here with Tommy the True Neubauer, who's in on or off the phones. Captain Bush, I don't know what to say about him. John Lehman, I'm just hanging around. We have 2 guests with us, Tom, Kep, and his son Dakota, Kep, and we've got on the YouTube trying to get us broadcasting, and what are you laughing at?
You!
Why? I'm getting it pretty good right now. And we have to go if you want to view us. It's YouTube.com/BeyondTheBarb365. And Maddie B behind all of the screens trying to keep us on the train tracks.
Good morning, Tom and son Dakota.
Good morning.
Good morning. Now, you guys are involved in a project with Walleyes for Tomorrow, correct?
You got it.
Can you explain exactly what you're doing, where you're doing it, and how you're doing it?
Well, we started a Pewaukee chapter of Walleyes for Tomorrow, and the main goal was try to get the young fry back in the lake. They just did fish studies in 2011 and 2012, and there was no Young of the Year walleye pike or northern pike.
Walleye pike?
Walleye pike.
That's what they call it, walleye pike, even though they're part of the perch family.
Yeah, there is no such thing as a walleye pike.
Well, Tom, you've lived on the lake for a long time, and I know I was talking with you about this, in that, you know, for years, the DNR has been stocking walleyes, and guys will get some decent ones now and then. What again, how many are being stocked by the DNR right now?
Well, the DNR has been putting in 80,000 every other year, but we missed one quota when they were tight with the budget, and the trouble is they're backing a truck in and they're dumping them in, but we have a huge abundance of perch and bluegills, so it's just lunchtime.
And how big are those walleyes that they were putting
in? You're talking about an inch and a half.
Oh, yeah, that's lunch, yeah.
So there's a limited amount of them that are making it. And I don't know, you know, I've never really done real well for walleyes out there. It seems to me that a lot of the big ones are caught by the ice fishermen because they're sitting out there and they put a lot of time and they get in the prime spots. And they get some nice ones, too. I was talking to Paul Mihalik, and he told me, way back in the 80s, he talked about how off Waukesha Beach, off the deep weed edge, he had gone a couple nights, and he got a 10 one night and an 11-pound another, and I was kind of dropping my jaw thinking, wow, on Pewaukee. But it sounds like this Walleyes for Tomorrow initiative is going to be a good one. Can you kind of explain how that the walleye wagon you guys put together and the plans now that for the stocking then and planting?
Well, it'll be in early spring of the year. We'll go out and put fike nets out and catch the big females that are ready to spawn and then bring them in and actually milk them out, get the milt, and fertilize them. And then this is a trailer that's 20 foot long by 8 foot 6 wide, and we'll basically be pumping Pewaukee Lake water out of the lake in a strategic location where it's deep, cold, clear, fresh water, and we'll have the eggs in actually hatchery jars, and we'll pump the water in, it'll go, and it'll get the eggs started, the fry will start, and the water actually comes through it and goes back into the water, and then we'll take the fry and actually take them out into the big lake in deep water where the predators aren't sitting there waiting for lunch, and release them like a siphon through the deep water.
So you're going to, rather than just like you said, like a DNR truck will just, I mean, limited, I mean, they can only do so much. They just back up and dump them in, and a bunch of predators, birds, a bunch of bluegills and stuff. So you guys are going to try and put them out in areas where they're going to be more likely to survive. And how many do you plan? Didn't you say it's like a million that you might be stocking, or, I mean...
Success rates vary, obviously, but Winnebago system, they've been doing this for 20 years, so they got the science down, and I think everybody knows how good Winnebago is, and that's a lot of credit to Walleyes for Tomorrow. Lake Geneva this year, I believe, released 6 million fry into there. They're Walworth County. It's their second year. They've had two very successful years, and some of the locals are catching some 8 and 10 inch baby walleyes out there, so they know the first year had some success. So that is the goal. It's actually fighting with numbers. Get as many as we can in there. We're going to have the predation, but if you get 1% of 6 million to live, how wonderful would that be?
So, and this should be an every year type thing then. So, you know, now is the DNR going to continue to do their every other year thing too?
Yep, DNR, I mean, it's great. We got Ben Huster, a young guy, just full of energy, wanting to do the right stuff. We talked about it when we sat down and talked about the lake plan and the fishery survey, and I said, let us help you, and I think you're finding that a lot more nowadays. The DNR is working with volunteer people. They know they're understaffed. They're getting volunteers that are ready to help, and he's exclaimed that he would help put them, instead of backing the truck up, I can get a flat barge with a big tank on it, and we'll put them in the tank. We'll go out to deep water. So even in their stocking program, we're going to help distribute the fish in strategic locations on the lake.
Hey, Tom, I got a question. How are you funding this with Walla tomorrow?
That's a great question.
I only ask great ones.
and actually, when we started the chapter, Walleyes for Tomorrow said they already did their budgeting for 2014. And I said, Mike Arrowwood is the guy I've met with. I said, I'll get enough people and volunteers and sponsors to fund this walleye wagon. And we're talking about $6,000. And literally, I came to the first meeting. And I had 30 people. The second meeting, 33 people, more different people. We are up to 137 members, and we actually have the walleye wagon just about funded already, and we didn't even do our first.
Wow. 138, wow. Tom. I mailed my thing last week. Didn't get there yet.
And we had lots of sponsors, Smokey's Bait Shop, Dick Smith's, the Corner, BP, a lot of people stepping up.
Hey, tell them how you guys whipped that, put that walleye wagon together, and amazing the Walleyes for Tomorrow guys, that local guys could get together and put it together like in 2 days.
Yeah, that was a great story. See, they like to build their own. They have the technology people, and they're kind of, want to do their own thing because they've done it so many times. I said, I got people, local carpenters and drywallers that are ready to go. If you bring the stuff down here, we'll help you put it together. Well, there was welders going, 2x4s flying, walls going up. He's stepping back, showing us what to do. Yeah. He said that the only reason we weren't done in 2 days is because he didn't bring everything down we needed. So it was.
He didn't know what the local boys could accomplish if they put themselves together, mm-hmm. Put their heads together. And the nice thing is, we'll work for beer.
And we had designated.
You didn't have
people,
to worry about union wages.
Designated people to go get the PAP.
Oh, wow.
Cook the burgers. So,
what about Dakota? Let's talk. Move that mic over. Let's talk to Dakota a little bit. Now, you can just pull that right up. So now you're involved with your dad with this?
Yes. Yeah.
And what do you find interesting about it? And,
it's great because more people are going to be able to be getting involved in this stuff. More people are going to be fishing, and there's going to be more walleyes in the lake. And I feel that's really going to help out the lake. So I'm really getting involved. I help put the walleye wagon together, mm-hmm. And go to all the meetings. But I think it's a great thing to do.
Are you learning a lot about how they're all raised and hatched and all that kind of stuff? Yeah.
Yep. I guess that'll be kind of coming up then this spring.
Yep, this spring. So we'll have people down there every day helping raise the fish, clean water, everything like that.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have someone down there every day. Well, it's in process.
You could teach a class like that in your school then, eh?
Probably.
Probably could, yeah.
Yeah, no, he was not one of them that won the contest for the statewide, but you've been involved in hunting, taxidermy, everything.
He's caught a lot of big fish. I see there's a picture of him and a sturgeon from the Wisconsin River. I saw that. A monster bass. You got like what, a 7-pound bass this year?
Yeah, with Dakota Lansky just fishing out on the lake.
What lake?
Pewaukee Lake.
Okay.
Right out towards just past Lakeside, down towards the west shore. Just with a straight rig or like a wacky rig. Cast it out into deep water. So.
Yeah, and I talked to Dakota yesterday, Tom, and I said, how's your bass fishing been going? Okay, nothing great. Got a 6-pounder this week, and I'm thinking, got a 6-pounder this week, nothing great. So you've caught a lot of nice fish, so you're avid and into it. How about your biggest walleye, though?
The biggest one, I don't know, it might be on Pewaukee ice fishing, but it might have been up on my cabin on the Wisconsin River. I'm not sure how big it was. What do you think?
I'd give him maybe 26.
26 inch. Okay, that's all right. 6.5, 6 pound, maybe 7 if real fat full eggs.
So are you looking forward to maybe Pewaukee becoming a walleye destination for anglers?
Yeah, definitely. Just like bass fishermen a lot are out on the lake. You know, bass have been doing great. You'll catch them all the time. Well, that's where we're going with for walleyes.
Mm-hmm.
And like a mini Winnebago.
So. Yeah, and the one thing I'd like to bring up is we have Jacob over here, and they work together at Smokey's, and it's these kids that are getting together to do something other than, I don't know, snap off hood ornaments and flatten tires. They're actually out there doing something and having fun doing it and helping the entire lake and the community at large, because it does bring people out, and it is a way of passing time in a good way, along with getting some food on the table and just the excitement of the hunt. And it's great to see kids of this age, where they're not even old enough to drive yet, they're out there doing all of the stuff that really nobody's done in a long, long time. And it's good to see kids back involved in it with Jacob. And when we get back from break, maybe we can just run through a few of the people, some of the kids that you've been working with over the past year, and how you guys got together to get this put together. And thanks to your father, Tom, who has also really been kind of a leader on this to try and get the walleyes going.
Yes. Go ahead. I was going to say 799-1250 is the phone number if you have any questions or comments about the Walleyes for Tomorrow Pewaukee Lake Initiative Project. 799-1250. Give us a call, John.
And Walleyes for Tomorrow does so many other things. I'd like to get into that also. You're listening to the Cutting Edge Outdoors on 1250 WSSP Milwaukee.
Just in case you missed the Wendy's Varsity Blitz scoreboard show last night, here are some of the winning coaches Big Time Mike McGivern and Hall of Fame coach Ron Davies caught up with. Head coach Matt Good from Tosa West.
Last year you had such a very good year, and it looks like this year some potential this year, although I know you want to just take it one game at a time.
Yeah, absolutely. We have some special athletes, and our kids understand what they need to do to get those guys the ball and don't make mistakes as far as turning the ball over and penalties. And we're going to put a lot of points, I think, all year. And it's fun for those linemen to get the block and do things like that for these guys.
Here is Coach Joe Cook from Brookfield Central.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. Yeah, it was a start. I got to play a lot of players. And, you know, we posted a 38-6 win. And, didn't have any serious injuries, but we played hard and played together. So it was a nice start.
And Wisconsin Lutheran's head coach on their team getting a big win.
Yeah, we're real happy right now, obviously. We didn't really know what to expect coming into the game. We were so up and down at scrimmage, but we got a real determined group. And I thought we had a great week of practice. And, came together for us tonight.
Be sure to tune in to the Wendy's Varsity Blitz scoreboard show every Friday night from 7 to 10 p.m. and follow that up with the Varsity Blitz Coaches Show Saturday mornings starting at 10 here on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Robert Hack Diamonds is paying cash for your gold.
I'm Jonathan Lucroy. Why aren't we talking diamonds?
I know Robert Hack has been open since 1947 and sold thousands of diamonds. I know Robert Hack also pays cash for diamonds. Why not advertise? You can't strike out at Robert Hack Diamonds, or hit a home run every time you buy a diamond, or buy a baseball-sized diamond at Robert Hack. I also know the news media trusts Robert Hack when selling gold and diamonds, as they all interviewed Robert Hack Diamonds for advice for their viewers. Robert Hack also carries the Pandora jewelry line, including a neat baseball charm. Green for your gold. Wait a minute. This is baseball season.
Jonathan, you're on the air.
Oh, sorry. Robert Hack pays green for your gold, silver, and diamonds. Come see Robert Hack, located in Glendale, on the corner of Green Tree and Fort Washington Road, and on the south side, on the corner of 76th and Layton. Visit RobertHackDiamonds.com. Robert Hack Diamonds, where they want your business.
Smokey's Muskie Shop, your St. Croix Muskie Rod headquarters. If you're a muskie angler that enjoys using the best equipment available, stop in and put your hands on the finest muskie rods on the market. St. Croix rods are made with the latest technology and highest quality components. The Mojo, Premier, and the Legend Tournament Series are all available at Smokey's Muskie Shop. For all your muskie fishing needs, it's Smokey's Muskie Shop. Call 262-691-9659 or simply go to smokeysmuskieshop.com.
Hi folks, this is Gorman Thomas for Interstate Heating. If you're like me, you want the very best Carrier heating and cooling system in your home installed by the best team. And that's why you need to turn to the experts at Interstate Heating. You can trust Interstate Heating. I personally have been using them for over 20 years to keep my family comfortable.
Plus, Interstate Heating can also help you get up to $1,575 cash back and energy savings on a Carrier Greenspeed Infinity system.
Call my friends.
When Sherpers claims they have everything for the great outdoors and more, they mean it. Camping, backpacking, hunting, fishing, paddle sports, water sports, and things you won't find at most other stores, like military surplus and everything to repair your outdoor gear. Clothing brands like The North Face, Columbia, and Woolrich. Footwear from Keen, Solomon, and Merrill. Old Town Canoes and Kayaks. And knives from Leatherman, Buck, and Kershaw. You're sure to find everything for the great outdoors and more. Sherpers in Hales Corners and Oconomowoc, and online at Sherpers.com.
You have to trust your butcher, and at Bucky's Fine Meats and Sausage, we take pride in having earned your trust because we only sell the best American-raised meats. Our mouth-watering sausages are made from the same quality meat and the finest herbs and spices. Bucky's Fine Meats and Sausage is located in McGuanago, just off of I-43 and Highway 83. Check us out at buckysmeats.com. If you want quality meat, sausages, and service, come to Bucky's. It's what we do.
This is Sheriff David Clark. Violent crime went up nearly 10% in Milwaukee. Are you the next victim? You don't have to be, but that's your call. Armed criminals are being put back on the street by a soft on crime court system even before the ink dries on police reports. Are you prepared to handle a life or death threat? Wisconsin's Personal Protection Act now gives you the same advantage that I have. Now it's the crook who has to wonder what you might do. Can be a great equalizer, but you always have to think survival. Remember, it's you and me now.
This public safety message brought to you by the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office.
Hey, this is Mike McGivern. High school football is back. Be sure to listen to the Wendy's Varsity Blitz High School Football Coaches Show this morning from 10 to noon. We're talking with Patrick Wagner from Milwaukee Riverside, only on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Did she say, hey, welcome back to the Cutting Edge Outdoors. Just want to remind everybody that if you got any reels, muskie equipment, let's say, for this fall's fishing, go to BadgerReelRepair.com to have those rods and reels repaired. Also, the ice fishing season is coming up, and Badger Reel Repair is also a certified repair center for Beaver Dam tip-ups. For more information, go to BadgerReelRepair.com. Also, we've got Gene on the line. Hi, Gene. Good morning.
Good morning, Tom.
Oh,
how are you?
This is Gene from the Prairieville
Desperados.
Thank you. I had a little brain fart there. Prairieville Desperados. This is a club that promotes quick draw shooting, right?
Yeah, it's actually called Cowboys Fast Draw.
Cowboys Fast Draw. That is just so awesome. I know I did a show with you guys for Outdoor Wisconsin last month and out at Wern Valley. And you've got quite a few members in your club, right?
Yes, we are. We're a pretty new club. We've been growing pretty fast. We started out with just two of us, and we're up to about 30 members in 3 years.
Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you what, it was a lot of fun learning how to do that and practicing it, you know. I think that's something that John Layman could really get into, you know. The only thing is we can't give him live ammunition, so there could be problems
We never use that.
Well, no. I mean, what you do is you've got that 45 caliber casing with a shotgun primer and a little plastic bullet in front of it.
Exactly. Yeah, that's all it is. It's about 5 cents a shot when you go to use it. So it makes it you know, a little more reasonable to be doing this.
Mm-hmm.
A little fun. It doesn't cost you so much. But you're using your regular 45 long colt single action revolver. So maybe you've already got one laying around and are wondering what else you can do with it. Well, this is something that you can do with it.
And what I was amazed at is that the majority of the club members were shooting that target, quick drawing, and there's a way they measure the time. They were doing it in like, everybody was less than a second, like half a second, 0.8 seconds. You know, I mean, that's pretty quick.
Yeah. There's a lot of people all over the United States that are actually at about 0.3 seconds.
Well, I've been practicing, Gene, and I'm going to give you guys a run for your money. I've been practicing.
All right.
Well, listen, thanks for calling. Where can people go if they're interested in the Prairieville Desperados Cowboy Quick Draw?
Well, they can go right to our website, which is theprairievilledesperados.com, or they can email us at prairievilledesperados@yahoo.com.
All right. Well, thanks for calling, Gene. We do appreciate it.
We have practices about every 2 weeks out at Wern Valley. So just give a call out there. They have our schedule. Or just stop out and see us.
That would be fun. All right. Thanks, Gene.
Great, Tom. Okay. We're looking forward to having you come back.
I'm going to. All right. See ya.
All right.
Okay, bye now.
She didn't invite me, did she?
No, I did. Yeah, you're going to go, John. We're taking you along. So let's get back to Tom Kep and his son Dakota with the Walleyes for Tomorrow, Pewaukee Lake Walleye Initiative. You guys, Bushy, you had some questions that you guys were going to get into?
I was talking with Tom, and maybe, I mean, you can just roll, Tom, as far as events, any other things about the club you want to share, how people can get involved as far as join. Now, I'll kind of preface that by saying I sent in my $25 to join for my single membership. Am I really a big, huge walleye guy? No. But I thought, hey, you know what? I want to help support. So even though, like, I don't have a lot of time, so like Tom was telling me earlier, you don't have to be committing yourself to, like, invest a lot of time. Some people might say, you know what? I don't have time to be involved. I really don't want to join. Well, you can still just send in your $25, and you're supporting it. And it's a great initiative for the local lake. So hopefully we can try and get a bunch of entry forms and so forth. You know, just a simple slip to fill in and send in with a check. Maybe out at Smokey's bait shops, people can pick them up when they're coming in or out. If you fish the area lakes, go ahead and support it. But I'll shut up here, Tom, and kind of roll with some of the things we were talking about.
Well, I think you hit it right there, Dan. It's, you know, it's not my club or anything. It's our club. It's all the people involved in the club. When we have meetings, we just throw it out there. What do you guys want to do? And we vote on it. And I think it's gotten everybody really excited. But to join, it's $25 for an annual membership for a single member. You can be a sponsor for $200. That's you get a walleye print, and it just helps fund all the projects. And some of the projects that they have besides just this walleye wagon is we do some woody structures where you drop trees in and have the branches down in the water, which supports the bait fish and again supports the walleyes. Rock reefs is something they've done up in Fond du Lac. But I'll get some forms down to Smokey's Bait Shop down there, and maybe out by Dick Smith's and some of the other places, and people can go online.
I was going to ask you, you know, John and I were talking this week that, you know, there have been other lakes like Long Lake up by Dundee where they put in that rock reef out there because Walleyes for Tomorrow had a project out there. Now, would that be conceivable that they might do something like that in Pewaukee to promote more natural spawning of walleyes?
That's exactly it. We've talked to Ben, who's a fisheries biologist, and what we're trying to do is look into, okay, instead of just doing a project, let's see where the walleyes are spawning. Are they coming into the rivers and using the current and the shorelines, or are they actually coming on to some of the existing rock reefs? And we're going to try and figure that out, and then we would do that. That's in the big plan, and we'd probably do it with flat barges, putting rocks on flat barges and taking them out. They don't do the winter time drops anymore because of potential for accidents and someone going down.
And then we've got some events coming up now as well.
Yep, we actually, October 5th is our first raffle. That was one of the requirements they talked about when we were starting the chapter. They thought, well, maybe we should have them do a raffle. But the reality is we already got to our goal and took care of the walleye wagon, and we want to do the raffle. And what we have is a Jiffy power auger. The propane auger is the first place prize. Concealed carry handgun for second place, and then cash for third place. We've had a lot of people step up with donations. Smokey's Bait Shop's got a pontoon rental for eight. Dick Smith had a tackle box with some lures. We talked about a bucket of baits from John over
we'll
there.
We'll be doing more with that walleye-related and unwalleye-related prizes.
How do we how do we go about getting raffle tickets then?
Raffle tickets are at the Beer Depot. That's right in on Highway SS right there. Otherwise, some of the members have them, but the Beer Depot's right on SS. It's kind of going to be the master one holding on to the tickets that members are selling. So members can go there and get tickets, or you could go there and buy one. Otherwise, you know, you can call any member. We do have a website. It's PewaukeeWalleyes.wordpress.com.
Wait.
PewaukeeWalleyes.wordpress.com.
WordPress.
P-R-E-S-S. .com.
.com.
And Bill Lasty and his wife volunteered and put that together, and that's going real good. So that's what's great about such a big group. There's so many people that have skills that come together and really make this thing happen. We do have February 22nd, Curly's Waterfront. We got a big ice fishery going out there. I expect that to be a big event.
Very good.
First one's October 5th, Gina Sports Shock.
Well, not like I ever go anywhere near a beer depot, but I'll stop by and pick up some tickets. And when we come back, maybe we can talk a little bit of ice fishery. I think we have to go to break now. Okay. You've been listening to The Cutting Edge Outdoors. We'll be back for the last part of the show. Hang on.
The 1250 Milwaukee Sports Report starts right now.
From the Legends of the Field Sports Radio 1250 Update Studio, I am Matt Bartle, Legends of the Field, a sports memorabilia company you can trust. Let's start with the Packers. They played host in Game 3 of their preseason to the Seattle Seahawks at Lambeau Field last night. The final was Seattle 17, the Packers 10. The only touchdown of the game for the Packers came from a one-yard touchdown pass from Vince Young. There might not have been a lot of offense in the game, but tight end Jermichael Finley feels good and likes the way him and quarterback Aaron Rodgers are communicating.
Like I say, being at practice every day, not missing a day, and just communicate. Communication is on point right now. Loving it, and I just can't wait to see what we got for 16 games straight.
The Brewers were also in action last night visiting the Cincinnati Reds. Young Brewers outfielder Chris Davis stayed hot, hitting two home runs, giving him four RBIs for the game. Second baseman Scooter Jeanette added a home run of his own, and the Brewers used that offense to get a win. The final was the Crew 6, the Reds 4. Garda was the starting pitcher. He went six innings, throwing 108 pitches, giving up three runs. Two of them were earned. Jim Henderson came in to shut the ninth to get the save. Other Brewers news, some teammates have commented on Ron Braun's apology for using PEDs. Manager Ron Renicki stated, "I don't care how people are going to tear this apart and critique it.
It doesn't matter what he says. Try to do what you think you need to do. WSSB's own Jonathan Lucroy also was quoted, "I thought this was a good first step on the road to redemption." Other news, former Marquette guard Dean Memminger has passed away at the age of 65. He was found deceased in his hotel room, and the cause of death has not yet been determined. Read more on all these stories at sportsradio1250.com. This sports update brought to you by Milwaukee County Parks. Get your group of friends and business partners together and a Book of Fun group golf outing. It takes 12 or more people to get discounted group rates at any of the county courses. Book your event for 12 to 144 people today. County Parks Town, or call the golf office at 414-257-8024. I'm Matt Butler, and you're listening to Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
On the next Bill Michaels Show, it's a Green and Gold Monday. We'll take a look back at the Packers and Seahawks with Paul Lemming of FoxSportsWisconsin.com and Eric Baranchek of the Green Bay Press Gazette. And after a weekend to mull it over, what are you thinking about Ryan Braun? It's the Bill Michaels Show weekdays 10 to 2 on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Your house is connected to your neighbor's house, and your neighbor's house connected to another one. Your whole block's connected to the sewer line, and if too many leak, your basement gets wet.
If you own a house, you own a sewer pipe, and leaky ones cause basement backups and sewer overflows for the whole neighborhood. We're all part of the problem, and we're all part of the solution. Get the facts at basementconnection.org.
Your neighbor's house connected to another one. Your whole block's connected to the sewer line, and if too many leak, your basement gets wet.
Want to look like a hero this weekend? The first ingredient is Rupinas. This week's specials, all of Rupinas' signature homemade hand-twisted sausage is on sale. Brats, Hungarian, Polish, or Italian, only $3.98 a pound. That's what we call grill candy. Rupinas, 76th and Bloy Road in West Dallas.
Waukesha Sports Cards is pleased to announce the first public autograph signings of Green Bay rookies Eddie Lacy, Dayton Jones, and Jonathan Franklin on Tuesday, September 17th from 6:30 until 7:30 p.m. Tickets are limited. Reserve yours now. Visit WaukeshaSportsCards.com.
Hi, this is Captain Mel Christensen. I'm a full-time fishing guide and would like to show you the great fishing that's available on Lake Delavan or Geneva, two of the best lakes in southern Wisconsin for bass or pike. I provide all the equipment, so all you have to do is book the trip and have a good time. Visit my website, fishwithmel.com, or call me at 815-678-7051. 815-678-7051.
For over 26 years, Midwestern Shooters Supply has been your premier dealer for hunting supplies. Their staff is friendly, experienced, and certified with over 16 years of gunsmithing experience. They are your one-stop shop for all your hunting needs. Their inventory is at the lowest possible price, and they will match any other dealer's advertised price. Do you do more than hunt? Hey, check out their full fishing line of products as well. Visit Midwestern Shooters Supply today or shop their web store at mwshooters.com. Midwestern Shooters Supply, they are your complete outdoor supplier. Call toll-free at 1-866-269-4995. That's 866-269-4995. Or just go to mwshooters.com. Auto Facelift is the place I can recommend. I've had to use their services several times and my vehicle has always turned out looking great. Auto Facelift is located on 125th and Lisbon. That's only one block north of Capitol Drive. Free estimates and they will work with your insurance company. Call Brian at 262-783-6059 or hey, just Google Auto Facelift.
Hey, this is Mike McGivern. Listen to the Milwaukee Area Home Improvement Show this morning starting at 9. John Phillips, owner of The Cabinet Maker, is this week's co-host, and our special guest is Dave Clark from Callan Construction, only on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Here comes old Rose, she's looking out of mine.
Hey, welcome back to the Cutting Edge Outdoors. We're just having one heck of a good time here in the studio.
Discussing non-things.
With our guests, Tom Kep and his son,
non-things.
Dakota.
Non-thing.
I am Tommy the True Neubauer, along with my co-hosts, things. Captain Danny Bush and John Lunge Lehman and Maddie B on the board. And anyway, you can watch us on YouTube right now at what is that again, John?
YouTube.com.
/beyondthebarb365.
All right. Did I catch you off guard there?
There's a delay in brainwaves between the neo and the cortex. There's this 1 second delay.
Tom, I got a question for you. You know, I would be really looking forward to Pewaukee Lake having a substantial walleye population.
Oh, it'd be great.
But do you think that an R might do something silly like they did on Lake LaBelle? You know, like a one fish, 20-inch limit. Yeah, I mean, or how do you feel about slot size limits maybe on Pewaukee Lake to ensure a more sustainable growth of the walleye fishery?
And where's the launch on North Lake?
Yeah.
But anyway. You know, Tom, that's something that's been brought up, and actually it's on our agenda for the next Walleye for Tomorrow meeting, which is first Thursday in September coming up. Ben has been there, the fish biologist, so he's the
probably
main
doesn't
guy.
Like me.
If I were him, you're already attacking him for what he hasn't done yet.
He's a good guy.
I know he's a good guy. No, I'm not. I'm not going after him. I'm just going after that slot sizes have been proven in Canada, Minnesota, places in Wisconsin. It is proven that it works. So. You know, why can't they do more of that?
Well, I wouldn't like Tom just on the principles, even being Tom.
Yeah, be quiet.
He's actually asking us, what do we want to do? Another one's the Northern Pike. You know, we don't have, people are taking the big spawners out. We need those in there.
And who said that spawning. Regulation?
And, well, that's...
The DNR with over 26 inches.
There you go.
DNR telling us, hey, take all the spawners. But they say they're trying to protect them, and they're really not. So there's another thing where a slot limit would be great again, instead of just going to, let's go to 60 inches, or something.
Okay, well, that's a big question. How many fish what size should be the mid-sized fish? And
yeah,
we're
gonna talk how do you guys feel about it? How do you feel about it?
You know, I think three fish, 18 inches would be fair, I mean, you can only have so many in your freezer.
Exactly. Oh, definitely.
Stocking up.
Definitely.
I mean, for what? They're not eating fish.
What is the current walleye limit on Pewaukee? What's the size? I don't even know.
Five fish, 15 inches.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, and that's
and three fish 18 inches would be fine, or even if they said three fish, that anything between 15 and 19 got to go back.
Yeah.
But well, you can keep three of any size.
It's good that
otherwise.
You guys are conversing, talking about this now, because if we do build big volume, we want to obviously have regulations that are going to keep it that way, and yet have people able to enjoy it. And have a few walleye fillets for the pan.
That's right. Yeah. Get enough to take home and eat and feed the family and go back the next day. And if you're dedicated and going back, you get enough to do it again.
Mm-hmm.
And meanwhile, you're keeping the fishery healthy.
I have to correct myself. I said three of any size. I meant one fish over that slot limit and two can be under.
Well, I do think it's important that we have fisheries now that do allow people to catch some fish, catch and consume, because... Mm-hmm. One of the things that a backlash, I think, against all this catch and release is you got a whole bunch of young people being raised that they'll just maybe shoot or catch something, but they never want to eat it,
clean it, cook it.
And I think there is a connection where my dad always taught me, okay, you go hunting, you shoot a squirrel, you're going to take the time, you're going to clean it, you're going to utilize it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And I think there is a connection that we can appreciate being able to go out and catch and get our own food and have that connection. I don't know if that makes sense.
Here's another question, Tom.
It does.
Will the increased number of walleyes in Pewaukee Lake reduce the number of small perch?
Good question.
That's a great question.
I only ask good ones. Okay.
There's so many perch in that lake. I mean, you put a tip down ice fishing.
I know, they're all 3 to 5 inches
staring at you. And that's the beauty of the walleye program is that's their main course, So getting walleyes in there and getting them a little bigger, they'll help take care of so many of those perch, and that'll allow the perch to get bigger, too, because they won't be all fighting over the same food source.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Dakota.
North or south?
Yeah.
He works for you, John.
As a matter of fact, there's another Dakota that's with this Dakota, and the Dakota is going to be North Dakota because he's about 6 foot six. And he's going to be South Dakota.
Yeah, that's but right. You, we were talking about that last week.
Yes. I just, and you too, Jason, or Jacob.
Boy, do you sound like a senile. He sounds more like a senile old man every week.
I fit the bill. Is how you got your program together. How did you get the kids together to do this? A lot of kids aren't going out and doing this. You get some kids that are bored and they go out and shoot somebody. You guys are doing something for the community, for the lake, for the for things to be passed on from generation to generation. How and why did you do that?
Well, no, we started out, you know, I started out as a kid just loving to fish, love the outdoors, and, you know, went to Pewaukee High School, still go there now, then worked at Smokey's Bait Shop. Well, me, Dakota Lenski, and Dylan Lenski, Dakota's brother, teamed up to, you know, shoot videos and stuff, which will help influence other kids. And it'll just be a fun thing to do, we thought. So we just like teamed up. We really met at Smokey's Bait Shop where we all three of us work. We knew each other in the school. Dakota's a junior, going to be a senior now this year. Me and Dylan are both going to be sophomores. So we didn't really know each other that well in school. But then the bait shop really brought us together. And we're like, hey, we all, you know, love hunting and fishing. So we came together and we all kind of, you know, had the thought of videotaping our hunts and our best fishing trips and stuff. So we just teamed up to do it together and agreed that we should try to, you know, do this, and it would be a cool thing to do.
I think you're doing a great job. And when we come back, we'll talk more with Tom Kep and his son Dakota about the walleye stocking program on Pewaukee Lake with Walleyes for Tomorrow. If you have any questions or comments, 414-799-1250 is the phone number.
Packers fans, let's head to Titletown for a Green and Gold update, brought to you by Paper Machinery Corporation.
I'm Mike Clemens in Green Bay. The Packers lose to the Seahawks 17-10 at Lambeau Field. The focus was on Graham Harrell, who got to run the first team offense. It was only 6 of 13 for 49 yards and no touchdowns.
Thought we got it in. They reviewed it and, you know, turned it back. And then we kind of moved the ball on that other one, had a turnover.
Vince Young took over in the second half, drove the team 80 yards in 11 plays with a one-yard touchdown pass.
You know, Coach McCarter was telling us as the second team and third team is to get a better tempo, get guys out the huddle. I really feel like the offensive line did a great job.
That's Packers quarterback Vince Young in Green Bay. Mike Clemens, WSSP.
The Green and Gold update was brought to you by Paper Machinery Corporation. Paper Machinery Corporation in Milwaukee is expanding and looking to hire a few CNC machinists. Apply for a job and get a career with Paper Machinery Corporation. Call 414-354-8050 or log on to papermc.com.
Just in case you missed the Wendy's Varsity Blitz scoreboard show last night, here are some of the winning coaches. Big time Mike McGivern and Hall of Fame coach Ron Davies caught up with. First up, Rob Green from Brown Deer.
Well, our offense, we broke out early, and then Milwaukee Roots in our last fight, they kept on coming back on us. And, you know, it was a hard-fought game, and we got to clean up some mistakes as we grow.
Maguanago's head coach Clay Iverson with his team's win over Racine Horlick.
I'll tell you what, I keep on in there. They played real hard. It was a game of a lot of different swings. I think you get that sometimes, especially in the first game, when you try to figure a few things out. But we hung in there well, and beat a quality opponent. They're going to win a lot of football games. So it's always good to get when you schedule a tough non-conference, and then you get an opportunity to win, that builds confidence.
And University Schools head coach Brian Summers.
Nice win against Milwaukee South today. Coach, congratulations.
Yeah, we played hard. A lot of mistakes, but we'll take a 48-0 win to start out the year.
Be sure to tune in to the Wendy's Varsity Blitz scoreboard show every Friday night from 7 to 10 p.m. and follow that up with the Varsity Blitz Coaches Show Saturday mornings starting at 10 here on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Johnny V here. My mom loves to eat fresh, scratch, homemade meals, and that's why I opened Moe's, named after my mom, Maureen, 10 years ago, and that's what you'll find here every single day. That and great local bands, too. Made in Milwaukee for Milwaukee. Mom also told me to take care of my friends, so I'd like to personally invite you in for a cocktail on me. Text IRISH to 71037. 71037. Text IRISH and get $5 off your next visit. See you at Moe's.
Channel your latest home improvement nightmare.
I pay these guys
guys all this f***ing money and still not right.
Home Sealed Exteriors, a family and owner-operated exteriors business unlike any other. Built on honesty and straight talk, their windows are based on true performance rating instead of a sales gimmick that the other guys use. Find Home Sealed Exteriors online at homesealed.com or give them a call at 414-545-0405. Home Sealed Exteriors. Seal your home with Home Sealed windows and siding.
When it comes to an adult beverage store, you need three things: price, selection, and service. Discount Liquor has the best price and weekly specials. Discount Liquor has the best selection with over 1,000 different beers, over 3,000 different liquors, and over 8,000 different wines. And the best service, including a very knowledgeable sales staff. Discount Liquor has two locations to serve you, 51st in Oklahoma and 919 North Barstow in Waukesha. Whether it's a tailgate party, birthday party, or a wedding, no order is too big for Discount Liquor. Discount Liquor is family-owned and operated business and has been serving their valued customers since 1960. You'll find the weekly specials at DiscountLiquorInc.com. They have my favorite bourbons and wines, and with their great selection, I'm sure they're going to have yours too. If you've never been to Discount Liquor, stop in and make some new friends.
Hunting season is here. Get ready for the best time of the year. Midwest Outdoors Magazine stands ready with you, loaded with tips, ideas, and destinations to make this the best fall ever. Get 12 big issues for only $14.95. Call 1-800-606-FISH. Each issue is packed with information and entertainment, including the Wisconsin section, featuring fishing reports on all area hotspots and updates on what every outdoorsman wants to know. Call 1-800-606-FISH and subscribe to Midwest Outdoors Magazine.
Spring is right around the corner, and the lake is soon to be open. When it's time to take a break from the water, come and grab some grub from Curly's Waterfront Pub. We serve the coldest tappers, great sandwiches, and have the best homemade pizza in town. We've got hard-to-beat happy hour specials and fantastic daily food specials, too. When the sun goes down, enjoy trivia on Thursdays, karaoke on Fridays, and live music every Saturday night. We are located on the south end of Pewaukee Lake by Smokey's Bait Shop. There's a still waiting for you.
There's big news at Skipper Buds. Sure, you know them for selling big boats, but did you know about their fishing boat lineup? Skipper Buds is now selling a complete line of StarCraft fishing boats. Let's not forget about pontoon boats. StarCraft offers versatile cruise and fish models. Plus, new this year, Harris Float Boat Pontoons, all powered by dependable Mercury engines. So if you're looking for the best price on a complete fishing rig, don't wait. Head on over to Skipper Buds in Pewaukee on Silver Nail Road. Check out their website at skipperbuds.com. That's skipperbuds.com.
Are you an experienced CNC turning and machining center operator? Component Engineering, Inc. is now seeking qualified applicants to fill positions in their CNC machining departments. Applicants must be able to do setup and editing on Fanuc and Mazak controllers. 5-axis and machining center experience a plus. Component Engineering offers an excellent benefit package. Qualified applicants apply in person Monday through Thursday between 6 a.m. and 3 p.m. or Friday mornings from 7 a.m. until 3 in the afternoon. Component Engineering, Inc. 1610 Independence Avenue, Hartford, Wisconsin. Call them right now, 262-673-0511. That's 262-673-0511.
Monday morning on Chuck and Wicket, you could win $1,000 at 8, plus the latest on Ryan Braun with our Brewers insider Adam McKelvey. Then at 8:15, we'll look back at Packers and Seahawks preseason game number 3 with our insider Tyler Dunn. We'll see you Monday morning on Chuck and Wicket on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
Welcome back to Cutting Edge Outdoors. This is Bushy.
Here it comes.
John Lunge, yep. Layman, Tom Niebauer, special guest, the Caps.
Yep.
Dakota and Father Tom. And Jacob.
And John.
And Maddie on the board.
Yeah, Maddie
on the board. And there's some guy, I think Norm's outside on the sidewalk. Hey, Norm's out there.
Norm!
We want to introduce everybody that's here.
Norm's here to wash
John's
the windows.
New truck.
We got a couple minutes left. So before we screw up and go off the air and say, oh, we should forgot to do this, how about some contact numbers there, Tom? If somebody's out there and they're like, hey, you know, I think I'd like to join. I don't have one of those slips to join. What are some contact numbers where people can get a hold of you, either for a corporate sponsorship, which they can do if you're a business, or for individual? So what do you got?
Well, if you want to dial up and call on the phone, it's 414-333 9603 or an email to thkoepp@wi.rr.com. That way I can get an email back to you, and what I've been doing for members that are just asking questions is send them previous emails that give a lot of the history and what we're doing and the events that are going on. It really tells a lot about the whole program. And then again, we talked about the website, pewaukeewalleyes.wordpress.com.
All right.
Very good. And then, now, Dakota, you said you've got a website as well with some, what, videos and so forth? Or yeah, what do you got going?
Yeah, we have a website so far. It's www.tripledoutdoors.com. And we got that name because it's Dakota, Dakota, and Dylan. So we ended up coming up with that name. And then we also have a Facebook page, Triple D Outdoors, like that. And we have a, you can contact us at our email, which is tripledoutdoors@gmail.com. So we're hoping we can get this started soon. I hope it'll work out. So
cool.
Is it Triple D, is it DDD Outdoors, or is it
Triple D? No, just D-R-I? Triple D, just one D, and then Outdoors.
Oh, the word triple. Three.
The word triple.
Triple, and then a D.
And I guess we've got a couple minutes yet, too, now. Oh, yeah, John, want to say
just,
something?
Yeah, all I want to say is just, hey, guys, thanks. There's only a couple of you guys in the studio right now. I know that you've got at least a half dozen, if not more, of active kids that are out there doing this. And really, I'd like to thank all of you kids for doing it. They're using not any taxpayer money. This is money that they're raising on their own, everything on their own. It's nothing that's bleeding anything else out. And they're making it for a better fishing fishery for now and in years to come. So thank you, guys. God bless and stay free.
Okay, with a couple minutes left, Tom, real quick, forage-wise for those walleyes on a lake, you said perch. What else do you think? Are they going to be thriving out there, all the little panfish and so forth? Or?
Yeah, what I've seen on the lake is the abundance of the panfish, even the bluegills and stuff. There's so many stunted panfish, perch and bluegill, that the walleyes are just going to have a field day out there. And the beauty of our whole situation is our lake is a good walleye lake, and we do have some nice big spawning walleyes in there. It's just the heavy predation of all the panfish, and so I think I'm really, really confident this whole program's just going to step up the whole system.
I'm looking forward to it.
Well, you know that, and even if we can work on the pike down the road, because perhaps that would take care of some of those stunted panfish out there and mm-hmm. maybe make it a better panfish fishery as well if we get more predators out there scarfing up those little ones.
You mentioned the pike, and the northern pike was something we talked about. Ben at the fisheries, when we first talked about it, he said he couldn't get them because the musk, if you stock muskies, you can't stock northern because the northern spawn first and then it'll eat the baby muskies. Mm-hmm. But in Pewaukee, we don't reproduce with the muskies, and they stock larger muskies, so we don't have that issue. We bought some wetlands, and he's going to stock some northerns in there. So
good.
Every lake's different.
And you know, the last few years, there have been more and more northern pike being caught on Pewaukee Lake, some nicer ones, too. So
yeah, Tom's brother will tell you that.
Yeah, some nice ones. Yeah.
Some on the GoPros
and
cameras now.
Exactly. So. Well, thanks for coming in today, guys. We do appreciate it. Walleyes for Tomorrow is a great organization, going to do a lot of great good, especially at not just on Pewaukee Lake, but they do a lot of good throughout the state of Wisconsin. And I want to thank all our callers that called in today, and thanks to you guys, Dakota and Jacob, for being here today.
And keep those big ones in the lake for the kids, guys.
Catch and release. Yeah. All right. Well, I guess
maybe a slot size limit.
Okay, keep Tom off of that. Yeah, geez, I'll be on the lake with. I'm gonna be out riding with Matt Groppi. I'm gonna be on the lake doing a little bit of ride around.
Pulling some people over, are you?
Well, I don't know what we're gonna be doing there. So
yeah, only if they have had bikinis on, right?
Yeah,
I gotta throw in that Matt was a big instigator of the whole walleye program too.
Good.
Matt Groppi, so he's been working with us and doing a great job.
See, the DNR is doing some good things, Tom. So
I pat him on the back.
We haven't even got the walleyes in the lake, and he's complaining about the limit that hasn't been set.
Hey, I pat them on the back when they do well.
All right.
Well, but I have an opinion.
Cutting Edge Outdoors. Talk to y'all next week.
Saint Russia, is it?
Every weekday from 10 till 2, don't miss the big unit, Bill Michaels. Only on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP Milwaukee. WXSS FM HD2 Wauwatosa.
I'm Marco Belletti. Yankees went into Tampa riding a five-game win streak, and they sent the AL ERA leader to the mound. The Hirooki Kuroda was tagged for 7 runs in 6 innings, including 4 long balls. First homers he's given up since June 30th as the Rays cooled off the Bombers 7-2. Jose Lobatone homered and drove in 4, while